some kind of, I guess, compromise when it comes to something like this, rather than saying if you're an illegal, you're an illegal and you need to get out,
right,
regardless of
no,
how you
I
got
here. Oh, no, I agree with you.
Place.
I think Congress should come up with that. That's their job. I'm
but
not a legislator.
But if the president can't somehow come up with some idea that's going to convince Congress that they need to be on his side, then what does that say about our president and his ability to show strength when it comes to issues that matter most to his voters?
Well, I think what it is, it's been a failure of leadership all around. First of all, he had a great opportunity to exercise leadership during the debt debate. He decided that he thought that was Congress's problem and that he was going to step away. It's been documented and said several times that Speaker Boehner had called over to the White House to engage the president, and his calls went unreturned. He did not
Shailen,
get a
that's
response
just, that's,
from
that's just not true.
Go ahead,
that
Richard.
Is very true, Richard. It is
that
very
is just
true.
Not true.
Speaker
I mean,
Boehner
the truth
has
is we've
said
seen,
that he called over to the White House
leadership.
And he didn't
we've seen
get
real leadership
any
from the president
I want
on the debt
side
ceiling.
On this now.
We've seen leadership from the president on the debt ceiling. What we saw was a Congress that was not willing to do anything. And let's go back and talk about what you said of Mitt Romney's record as Massachusetts governor. As Massachusetts governor, the state was 47th in job creation in this country. So when it comes down to records and it comes down to working on the economy, the president has Mitt Romney point blank period. We've created 4.3 million jobs. We've had 27 months of consecutive job growth in the United States. And on top of that,
with
the president has pushed for the Dream Act. Has pushed for the Dream Act, and the people that are standing in the way of the Dream Act are not Democrats. It's Republicans. It's John Boehner. It's Mitch McConnell.
You're assuming that the Congress is completely Republican. It is half the Democratic senators have yet to put forth a budget. That's their constitutional
Listen, but we're talking about the Dream Act. You're mixing apples and oranges.
When no,
the president
I'm not.
Tried to
Actually,
pass,
I'm talking
when the
about
president
leadership
tried to pass the Dream Act
at
in the lame duck Congress,
to put the, blame
the Republicans
at
made it
Republicans,
because they because you need six because
just
of the
not
filibuster.
Accurate, Rich. It's just not
the
accurate.
The Republicans made it impossible for him to get the Dream Act through because of the filibuster. They blocked the Dream Act because they did not want to give people who came to this country as no fault of their own a chance of the American dream.
And what have the Democrats done? The Democrats
we
have not come up
Nancy
with
Pelosi
either.
Passed the Dream Act twice out of the House of Representatives.
He's not exercised any leadership on immigration.
Nancy Pelosi
I mean,
passed the Dream Act twice out of the House
of
Representatives.
One-third of the
Nancy
branch
Pelosi
of government
passed the Dream Act twice out of the House of Representatives. When it got to the Senate, Mitch McConnell and Republicans that do not believe in the American dream for people who came to this country at no fault of their own stood in the way of progress and blocked it with the filibuster. Point blank, period.
Sherilyn?
Well, he's welcome to, you know, I've laid out the facts. He talked right over me. But the fact is, it is not the Republicans' fault. They only are in power in one branch. It's the Democrat senators who have yet to even pass a budget. So even before we talk about immigration and the lack of this president's leadership on immigration, I mean, you still need all of these people to come together and work together, and the Democratic senators have not been willing to come together and work on a budget, which they failed to pass. The House Republicans have passed countless job economic bills, which the Democratic senators have refused to even...
Which bills are those, Cheryl?
Several of them.
Are those
you know
the
that there have been
those,
at least over 20 of those bills.
Are those the bills that would cut
bills.
Food for mothers, women, for infants, mothers, and children? Is that the same
That's
bill
not,
that would
cut... You know,
is that the same budget
the
that will roll back Pell Grants for college
Democratic
students?
Democratic talking points of instilling fear in people.
It's not a matter of fear.
All the Democrats
it's the facts.
Do is attack, attack, attack.
It's the facts.
And you have not presented a plan to put the country back
That's
on track.
That's just not true.
It's been
That's
failed
just not
leadership.
True. The president has proposed a budget.
Why Congress can't come up with any kind of solution because we have a Republican and a Democrat here on the set, and we can't get anybody I mean, can you guys can't agree on the, is the Dream Act a good idea? Can you guys agree on that?
I mean,
I definitely
why is it that we're only focusing on immigration? I mean, there are so many
no,
issues
I understand, but
that
let's
there's
just
been failed leadership
so we can move on.
In general, and I
Sherilyn,
think the
do you
immigration
think the Dream Act is a bad idea?
I don't necessarily think the Dream Act would be a bad idea if we could come together on a number of other issues that are affecting this country. And when you take the Dream Act in a vacuum and you take it against all of these other economic issues, I think that's why Americans are having a problem, because they see this one part that's going to cost this much money. And if you take that against the backdrop of our economic problems, of our debt issues, people are reluctant. And I would say people on both sides of the aisle are reluctant to yet push forth another program when we've got some other programs.
All right, Anthony
Fix
here on our live chat writes,
"I
think it stinks, but to be honest, I don't see any way to deny them the education."
I mean, that's part of the problem, Julie. The truth of the matter is that people, what the facts are the facts. The DREAM Act will actually save this country money and it'll make this country money by giving these students a path to citizenship and giving them a chance to get an education to contribute to our tax base in the long run. On top of that, they also decrease the cost that we spend on law enforcement because they would be actually be legal in this country. The fact that the Republicans can't agree on the DREAM Act,
Cheryl points out the problem. Cheryl
points
out the
problem. Hold on, let him finish his thought.
She points out the problem in the Republican Party. They are not willing to do anything for middle class and working class American. They don't want to give everybody
That's
the American
totally
dream besides
false.
Millionaires and billionaires.
That's totally false.
That
All
is
right.
just country boy exec,
what
by
I
the way,
to
online
be
chat. Sherilyn, you can react to this, and then it's going to have to be the final word. Country.